You're listening to Free Sense a Minute, an adult podcast for those that are 18 or older.
If you're not 18, shut this the bleep off.
It's all about sex, sex, sex.
It's Maggie here from freesenseaminute.com. I am totally excited to kind of bogart this episode because Kelly's having some internet issues. So, woohoo! I get an excuse to have a double little thingamajigger. We'll see what's going on with her internet later this week. I might be able to do a whole week's worth of podcasts with you. Wouldn't that just be lovely? Anyway, I have some housekeeping to get out of the way. Number one, I want to talk about our membership page. It's a smidgen. We have our next live conference chat where Kelly and I are going to be on the phone live, taking questions, interacting with members next Friday night at 7 p.m. Eastern. So it's going to be 7 to 8 p.m. Eastern Friday night. Sign up at the membership page. It's $7 a month. And every week you get a 1 hour session with us. And so, depending on who shows up live, of those questions might be all filthy, nasty, dirty stuff, or they might just be really normal, anyway kind of stuff. So really, you know, you decide, what the conversation is going to be. If nobody shows up and it's just Kelly and me, then surely we'll come up with something. And, we'll be recording those episodes and posting them on our membership page for future enjoyment, I guess. I don't know. So if you really want to guide the conversation, you got to show up live. This week, it's going to be Friday at 7 p.m. Eastern. It won't always be Fridays, but that's just what happened to work out with my with our schedule this week. The membership page is also really up in the air. You know, we're in the works of a ebook right now about how to get into phone sex, how to get into the adult industry, some of the things you need to consider and stuff you need to do, steps you need to take. We'll be compiling that and posting it by the end of the month. And then, you know, we're just really open and available to do lots of different things. We've got some requests for some dirty audio, so we will definitely be posting those on the membership page. You know, audios that at our own business, there's something we would sell for $20, $30, $40, $50. We're going to be selling right there on the membership page for free. All you need is the access to the membership page, which is just $7 a month. So we'll have those posted. And once we do, I will let you guys know so you will know what is going on. But again, membership is only $7 a month and you'll get access to everything on that membership page once you sign up. Now, the sign up is a little confusing, so I just want to do this little tiny tutorial. What you do is you go to freesenseaminute.com and there's a click for membership page over to the right. And it'll say you need to log in to make this happen, right? You can't view this without logging in. So you go to the login page and then it's just like a normal WordPress admin thing, right? It's a page that you would normally see if you were a WordPress person. Now down towards the bottom, there's a little button there that says register. So you click on that one. It says register. You fill out your name and your email. That's all the information we need. And then it clicks to our payment page. And the payment page is just says CC Bill. And it's like an icon for CC Bill. It's basically giving you options, but CC Bill is the only option that we have. Because we're adult related, we can't use PayPal or some of the other things. CC Bill is the only place that'll give us a merchant account for adult stuff. So you have to click on the CC Bill logo, and once you go in there, then it's just a normal, regular credit card page. And again, all your information is completely safe. CC Bill takes care of all of that. I don't see it. I don't want to see it. I have no access to it at all. So you just fill it out there, and CC Bill takes care of all of it. The $7 a month initial payment, and then it renews the payment 30 days. It's very easy to cancel. If you have any problems at all, email me, and I'll talk to CC Bill for you. So that's that. The other thing I want to talk about just really quickly, I have been DJing over at Climax Radio. And if you've never been over there, it's a really great, it's an internet radio station. It's been around for about 5 years. They're kind of in a transition now where they're changing owners, but it's still a rocking place. It's Climax with a triple X, radio.com. Obviously, they're kind of filthy, nasty, dirty people and just my type, and I fucking love them. But anyway, I've been DJing there Monday and Tuesday nights from 8 to 10 p.m. Eastern. So if you want to catch one of my shows, awesome, rock on. I play 80s rock music, and I also just, you know, I'm me. I'm Maggie. So I'm talking about phone sex, and I'm talking about funny stuff, and it's just a grand old time. So if you have the time or if you want to check it out, make sure to go to Climax with a triple X, radio.com, and hang out. Enjoy. They've got forums over there. They've got a lot of stuff going on, and it's just really cool people. A lot of international people. Lots of people from across the lake. So that's awesome, too. And they've got a ton of DJs, and yeah. So if you're into adult radio, and who isn't? Come on now, somebody. come on over to Climax with the triple X, radio.com. All right, that's all the fun little administrative stuff out of the way. Be sure to let me know if you have any ideas or things that you would like to see happening, either via our Facebook, via our Twitter, via our, you know, just our site here at freesenseminute.com. We're all about it. We're all about knowing what you guys want. So if you want some filthy, nasty audio about some particular fetish, let me know. I'll make it happen. I love that shit. Anyway, moving on. What else? Oh, let's just do the regular show, right? Oh my gosh, I can't believe I wasted 5 minutes on that crap. But anyway, it's stuff you need to know. So this episode, I know last time I kind of talked about some funky calls that I've had. Well, this episode, I want to chat just a smidgen about, you know, how do you date or how do you tell people what you do if you are a phone sex operator? This is a question I get all the fucking time. Like, all the fucking time. Because, you know, people want to know, like, you know, at some point you have to tell people, right? I mean, you can't. But then do you really need to tell everybody your business? It's kind of one of those things, because when I first started doing phone sex, I didn't tell anybody. I told everybody I did customer service from home, and I came up with different companies, and I would say all this bullshit. And it was really because I was embarrassed, more than anything else. Now I'm much more comfortable with the fact that, you know, I'm a phone sex operator and I make a ton of money, and fuck you if you don't like it. So, and I have, you know, I'm really open and honest and that sort of thing with everybody in my life. The only person that doesn't know is like my 80-year-old grandmother. So I don't really, you know, I don't worry about her finding out. So I'm just really open and honest about being a phone sex operator. And that translates to when I meet new people, whether I think they might be someone interesting to date, not that I'm really much of a dater, but whether or not I think they'd be an interesting person to hang out with, or, you know, any sort of thing. You have to kind of walk that line. When is it appropriate to show your cards, right? And when you work in the sex industry, I mean, I'm not a porn star. I'm not an escort, but I do, I mean, I consider myself a sex worker. I do work in the sex industry. What, like, where's the line? What do I do? And it really depends on the situation, obviously. You know, you kind of, like everything else, you have to go with your gut. If I'm getting drunk off my ass at a bar, I probably shouldn't tell some, like, redneck that, hey, I'm a phone sex operator, just for safety reasons, right? Like, you don't want that person to follow you home. You know what I mean? Unless you want them to follow you home, but then you don't want them to, you know, rape and kill you because they're like, oh, well, she's a phone whore, so she'll take it, you know, like any of that bullshit. So you have to be a little safe about, you know, obviously safe about, you know, that sort of thing. I keep going around the world on that. But other than those situations, I'm really open about it. And it's really more about, you know, what's convenient for the other person. If I'm hanging out with someone who's very prim and proper and I know that my job would offend them, then I'm much more likely to lie. And it's not really for my sake, but for theirs. You know, if I'm having lunch or something with one of my old Bible college friends and they're chit-chatting about, like, you know, going to Nigeria on some mission trip and how much they love Jesus and all this stuff, and we're eating over lunch, I'm not going to be like, hey, guess what I do? Now I'm a fucking phone whore. You like that? Like, no, that's offensive and it's mean. If they ask you what I do, I don't want to cause any issues in that situation. I might say, hey, I have customer service or I work from home or, whatever. And I sometimes I just boldface lie because, sometimes you need to do that for the sake of the other person. Now, when you're dating, I have this really funny story. When this fuck buddy of mine, really hot dude, I got him off of Craigslist. I know, I'm a Craigslister girl. I love that shit. It's like faster than Chinese for cock. So I like to get on Craigslist. I found this guy on Craigslist last year. In fact, our 1 year anniversary is here in a couple weeks. And he and I, he came over, we did our little dance. Hey, 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 how you doing? We went back in the bedroom and fucked like bunnies, right? And when we were done, he asked me what I did for a living. And I said, oh, I work from home. And I was still a little uncomfortable. I was like, whatever. And he goes, are you a phone sex operator? And of course, I acted like completely offended. Like, oh, how could you dare say that to me? That's so, oh. And then he goes, because you like narrated. Like the whole thing. And he totally called me out. And I was like, oh, I am a phone sex operator. And so now when I fuck that guy, I'm like really careful to like not talk too much. Because I'm like, oh, I'm narrating. Give me that big fat cock. Oh, yeah. I'm like, oh, my gosh, I need to stop. So anyway, that was like the best having to share my job with someone experience ever, because he totally called me out on it. I thought that was great. Anyway, so just like anything else, you're gonna have to, there's a dance. Some people are already married when they get into phone sex, and so in that situation, obviously you would tell the person up front. And I'm not a commitment person. I'm not a relationship person. I haven't even had fuck buddies for more than a year. So I don't know anything about anything when it comes to sharing your everyday life with someone. So I'm not.